the bread of life. Good day to everybody. This is day 16 of our Lenten journey. And today's antiphon reads from Psalm 139, verse 23 to 24. Test me, O God, and know my thoughts. See that my path is not wicked, and lead me in the way everlasting. This psalm is actually in conjunction with our reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. And it kind of also coincides then with Psalm 1, which is also given for our liturgy today, the Mass readings. And it talks about this idea of testing the heart. The verse from Jeremiah, chapter 17, verse 10-ish, goes, I, the Lord, alone probe the mind and test the heart, to reward everyone according to his ways, according to the merit of his deeds. You see, the Lord goes out and he says, hey, you have free will. And with that free will, you can do things in accordance with my law or in accordance with your own will and your own way of living. And you can kind of take things the way that you want it to be. Well, what God wishes us to do is to align our hearts with God's will, our free will going along with his. And that is how we will then will be successful and be abundant, right? And here's this beauty of this reading is that the just man who follows the law of God, he is like a tree by a stream, and he's receiving from that stream, which in the way it's reads is basically the law of God. God streams and pours forth his abundance to us so that way we can live and be gathered up in that abundance of God's word and his love for us. And then we share, we bear fruit, and others can come and receive from us that beauty of that word. We become the living and effective word to others. Wicked man, though, says, it's all about me. I will take things, I will make things the way that I want them. That, though, is a tree planted in a lava waste. See, there's no gathering and receiving of the word of God and in line with God and his will. And so it becomes empty and void. This is the testing that God is looking at. How are we receiving his word and using it and putting it into our life and sharing it with others? How are we being generous, giving to those generations? I hope that your Lenten almsgiving today is something that we look at a little bit more. How are we being generous with our time, with our talent, with our treasure? But not only necessarily those things, how are we being generous to the people that are around us, considering them, looking at them, paying attention to them? The gospel for today is the parable of Lazarus and the rich man. Lazarus sits outside the rich man's house and the rich man does not give. But the rich man knows who Lazarus is. And when they finally die and go to heaven, Lazarus is kept from going to be generous towards the rich man who is in hell, and he sits in suffering and torment in the lava waste. May we today be considerate of those who are around us in generosity and love, so to be the abundant and living and wondrous words of God towards others. Have a good Lenten journey.